playing?
No, I was a ball handling forward, Kevin, and it served me well, but I was not a guard. I was a forward that could dribble and pass fairly well.
So you were ahead of your time because that's all we see now in the NBA, right? Guards are not always bringing the ball up.
Yeah, you know, somebody just mentioned that to me, Kevin, that I was maybe a tad ahead of my time back in the
'80s. Sacramento's shooting their first free throws in the game right now. He's off on the first.
Probably a little draft in the arena tonight. He's the last guy you expect to miss the mark by that
much. Boy, I like the focus and unselfishness Fox brings to the court. A strong defender with lightning quick reflexes in every spot.
Now, here's Bagley. Lays it up off the glass.
And once he got to the 10, I think he was surprised to find himself that wide open.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not this.
The 76ers shooting their first free throws of this. No good on the free throw. Good on the second free throw. So it's Bogdanovich who brings up the ball for the Kings. Drops in the layup for two.
He does not lack for confidence. He should. I mean, this guy is a dangerous scorer.
Simmons inside the line. He doesn't hit that one. And Ben Simmons picks up the foul. That's foul number two for him.
He needs to get himself under control here. That's two fouls in less than 60 seconds.
First quarter, just over a minute played. Fox. And it's blocked by Embiid.
Boy, supported by great vertical explosiveness, Embiid continues to dominate as a rim protector.
Harris misses.
Yeah, trying to get going here, but that's an over for the first five here to start the game.
The Elite misses. And Greg, Al Horford over the summer opting out of a contract with Boston, the final year with the Celtics. A bit of a surprise to fans.
You know, Horford said he wanted to test free agency. Talks between him and Boston abruptly ended. Was wooed by several teams, but ultimately signed on with the Sixers.
Yeah, I love how Fox uses that wiry frame of his. He's eel-like in his ability to get to spots he wants to get to. He's always under control despite playing at a high rate of speed.
And now Sacramento on the break. And finished off by Bagley.
And he can do a lot more damage to the rim than that.
Oh, you're right. And with the lead they're enjoying, I'm surprised he didn't put a little something extra on that one.
Well, I think he did plenty of damage nonetheless. I mean, it was only with one hand, but he still threw that down pretty hard.
Here's Burks. And that's an air ball. Not even close. And the call will be against Harris. That is his first foul of the game.
And the next one puts him in the bonus.
Yep, they'll be trying to draw that next foul quickly so they can start getting those easy chances at the strike.
Boy, he is looking confident. Love how they're using him so far.
And you know what? They're going to keep using him. I mean, he'll be the centerpiece of their offense today. You can bank on that.
Offensive rebound. Here's Embiid. Shoot again. Shot off that time, and the Kings going the other way now. Bogdanovich with it, and Burks picks him up defensively. Here's Bagley. A chance to extend the lead to double digits, but it's no good. Here's Bogdanovich, and Horford pulls it down.
The defense ready for him on that possession. They had to be, because he is so strong in the paint.
Love the way Embiid knows how to play with force down low, which in turn makes the defense get physical with it.
And he can't get the first one.
And you look at Joel Embiid, Clark, for a player standing 7'2", probably close to 300 pounds. You've got to be impressed with how well he moves out there.
And Kevin, that's the first and most eye-catching thing about him when I watch him, is how nimble he is for his size. And you notice it at the offensive end because he's got great skills and footwork, but defensively, he doesn't pick up a lot of cheap fouls despite having the primary role of rim protector for his team.
Robinson misses. Sacramento leading by 9. It's Bogdanovich on the wing. And 2 free throws coming up. Unable to get that one to go with all the contact.
Yeah, way to play in attack mode and get to the line.
And, you know, the defense gets their money's worth on that foul. Stopping the layup and not giving up the and one.
And so Bogdanovich nails both of them. Here's Embiid. Bagley with the rebound.
You know, you'd like to see a little more effort there defensively, but maybe they wanted him to take that shot, baiting him into it.
Displaying intensity right off the opening tip, especially on the offensive end.
Tell you what, forget about easing into the game. They came out with guns blazing.
He can be a matchup nightmare if he can get it in the paint.
And stolen by Scott. It's 3-on-3 on the fast break. Shoots. The shot will not fall. And the Kings going the other way now.
And right from the start, Kevin, they've been pounding the glass. Most of those 50-50 balls also going their way.
Well, I don't think there's any question about it. They came focused and ready to play. I mean, they're doing everything they can to put things in their favor. You earn that. And they're actually earning it well right now.
With the block.
And a skilled shot blocker to boot. Love how Bagley uses that height and reach to stifle shooting.
The Kings have gone 3 of 4 at the free throw line tonight. He's perfect from the line this time.
He's as solid as it gets from the line. I mean, give him the opportunity, he's cashing in on those.
Pass to Milton. It's hauled in by the Kings. And it's in! Oh, he nails the buzzer beater! And so it's Sacramento. And glad to have you with us, folks. Second quarter of basketball. This game has not exactly been neck and neck, but plenty of time left in this one. And when you consider how the Kings are doing, guys, what are your thoughts?
You got to credit their defense, communicating, rotating, making plays on the ball.
They've got them rattled. It's only the first quarter, and already they've made enough big plays on defense to last really an entire game.
And with the playoffs ahead, some have argued for a play-in tournament, Clark, to determine the 6-10 seed. What do you think of that?
An interesting concept. In theory, it certainly might allow for more teams to be engaged down the stretch. You know, with Adam Silver, he's very much interested in seeing how to make the game better in every way. So there are no sacred cows. Just because it's been done one way before doesn't mean that he's not looking at ways to change it for improvement.
And keep that fan base really interested.
Yeah, that's a big part of what's made the league as successful as it has been worldwide.
Here's Embiid. And he gets the whistle. 2 free throws coming up.
You know, guys, it's not surprising to hear that Joel Embiid gets a lot of inspiration from Hall of Famer Hakeem Olajuwon. Both came to the game late. Both represent the continent of Africa. And Embiid really kind of modeled his game after Hakeem, and that's a heck of a model.
That one misses, so he goes 1 for 2. And when he first came to America, you know, what a great story this is. Embiid's coach in Cameroon sent him a DVD of Hakeem's highlights.
And that was a good start for Embiid. And good work by you, Kevin, to dig up that factoid. Very nicely done. But you're right. Embiid said he watched that tape every day for 3 years. And you can see evidence of him watching that tape and how he plays.
Now, here's Joseph. Score of the basket. Nice shot after missing his first attempt. And taking a quick look here, guys, at the hustle stats for Sacramento.
Great hustle defensively through the first half, contesting everything and racking up the block shots.
Something else they've done right so far from the get-go tonight is run. I mean, so much of their offense has come off the fast break.
Here's Simmons. After two misses to start the game, he's on the board with that shot made.
Yeah, you got to box out Simmons. It's plain and simple, guys. When you don't, he can really hurt you on the offensive boards.
Okay, well, let's go down to David Aldridge for a report from the sideline.
Well, Kevin, last season the G League tested out an expansion of the clear path rule. Now that expansion is making its way to the NBA. It should discourage those intentional fouls that slow up teams on the fast break. Fans wanted it, and analysts clamored for it. That will allow the amazing athletes in this league more opportunities to show what they can do on the fast break.
You're right, David. A welcome change. Thank you. And the call will be against Al Horford. That's his third foul of the game.
And that's the tough part of trying to keep him on the floor. Now he picks up that third foul.
And that one goes out of bounds. Last touch by Simmons. Here in the second quarter, we've played a little over 2.5 minutes now. Sacramento moving it around. Back to Bazemore. Shot clock at 6. And so it looks like the Kings will retain possession here.
Great instincts from him to get a hand on that pass and tip it out.
And, you know, even though they didn't come up with the steal, that's still a nice defensive play.
Philadelphia throws by 18. Kept alive. Harris's shot is off.
And with him missing literally everything he's put up today, you can see why the score is what it is.
For Sacramento, they have shot 5 of 6 at the foul line tonight. He misses the free throw. And he's good on the second. Clark Kinkis inside the halftime locker room in the NBA.
Well, players typically just regroup individually. There may be some conversation between the players as a group, but then the coaches will huddle, evaluate what transpired in the first half, what adjustments need to be made, and then they'll communicate that to the team. And it's basically a time to rest and regroup for the players to adjust and strategize for the coaches.
Clark, do you think there's any videotape review in there, maybe showing players certain sets, certain schemes?
In this day and age, for sure, with the use of iPads and technology, if you go back to my time, there was no quick turnaround of video in the halftime locker room.
Right, right. I do know officials do that, too, in their locker room at halftime.
Guys, this hasn't been his quarter. I mean, to me, just doesn't look completely comfortable or confident.
I love the ball movement there. He put that on a silver platter. He just served him up.
Out of bounds, it'll be 76ers ball. And the 76ers making a change here. Burks looking around. And the ball out of play. The Kings will inbound. Sacramento leading by 19. Here's Fox. And the basket for the fourth time from the field. He's a healthy 4 for 6.
Man, I like how confident Fox is inside. I mean, awesome. Absolutely awesome. Getting good positioning close to the basket.
Here's Barnes. Offensive rebound. And Fox gets it to go. Fox is got 11 points.
His shooting has been outstanding. Definitely one of the reasons they're up in this game.
Horford, no luck.
Oh, you've got to be able to deliver when you get a bunny like that. That's just too easy of a shot to miss.
The Kings shot, 8 of 10 from the line. That's an even 80% free throw shooting here. And so here is Philadelphia. Next up will be a home game matchup against the Pacers. And that will be the third of five straight played at home. Philadelphia shooting their seventh and eighth free throw attempts for the game right here. No good on the second free throw. The drive by Barnes. And the dunk by Barnes.
Up high and down hard. Love seeing Barnes be aggressive like that, Kevin. Showing off his quickness and athleticism in a big way. How was my impression of
good?
One of your favorite lines.
I like that. You sounded great. Better than me. I love it, Clark. Good job. This is his first chance at the line tonight. That's good from Barnes.
Man, you got to appreciate the overall game of Barnes. He's efficient as a scorer and also works hard at the defensive end.
And they've had their difficulties from the line here in the second. Could extend their lead if they just make some more free throws. Offensively, defensively, they are in total control.
And don't leave out the coaching staff here now. I mean, their game plan has been perfect.
And really, the potential Bagley has is so exciting. Just an absolute menace on both ends. And you can tell he wants to be great.
Bogdanovich, no luck. And so it's Sacramento. Having no problems at all. Up 29 points heading into the next quarter. The scoring has been tremendous, and they are shooting lights out with very high accuracy. We'll take a quick break, and then back to the action here. Well, we've got a second half of basketball for you. We think it's going to be pretty good. A big comeback, though, is needed for this game to be competitive, and it probably has to happen quickly. Right side, Fox. Shooting foul as the whistle blows. He'll shoot two free throws. These are his third and fourth free throw attempts of the game.
And, you know, something I remember from their last game was how good he was at the line.
Yeah, I agree with you. I mean, he attacked, got to the line a bunch, and cashed in on his chances.
Bagley with the block.
They've shown some strength in the paint today. Their work on the boards has been impressive.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
How frustrating for the defense. You get the stop, but then fail to block out.
Well, you know, that's the way it's going to be for them today, fellas. Can't sustain any momentum.
Richardson, that's a two-pointer. And it's Sacramento with the rebound.
Boy, he knows he should have knocked that one down, especially with the defense not giving much of an effort.
Great teamwork punctuated by a strong finish.
That is the perfect fast break, guys. Getting a hoop before the defense can get set.
Well, some ups and downs for Marvin Bagley in that rookie campaign with the Kings. But you can see the flashes of potential and the tremendous work ethic when he was out on that floor.
They found a nice groove in this half, starting out 3 for 4.
Richardson, the bounce pass. And a wide open look for Simmons. The 76ers with another miss. And with Bagley, the mobility he showed for his size is really what impresses me.
And that blend of size and speed is why many feel like he can play across the entire front line. Wasn't in the Rookie of the Year race, but in a few years, he could be right there with the best of the best from that 2018 class.
Guys are looking for a spark here.
Yeah, a cold stretch offensively, for sure.
It's Bialica. And that one's good, Barnes. Barnes has got 8 here in the quarter.
And he's caught fire this quarter, yet to miss a shot.
From deep 3-point range, but they recover it.
And the offensive rebounding, really the story here today. Even with the big lead, they're still showing more hustle on the boards. hey, whatever adjustments they made at halftime, they are working to perfection.
You know, they came out of the locker room, revved up the gas pedal, and haven't slowed down yet.
What a tremendous ability to hit from so far out. It's a big time three.
Here's Richardson. Richardson missing again.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. And tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Clearly, he's one of the best there is in the business when it comes to making that lead pass.
And Embiid has got the ball here for the 76ers. Richardson, good. Richardson's got eight. Clark, you were so prolific in so many areas of the game. Which part of basketball came the easiest for you?
I think the rebounding piece. I always had a knack for sniffing out missed shots and had the size and timing and hands to chase down rebounds. But that was probably the strength of my game and the most unique part of it at an early age. And then the ball handling. My dad was 6'4 in the 50s, which meant you pretty much played inside. And he drummed into my head and my heart. Make sure you can handle that ball. So from the time I started playing, I was dribbling and making sure I could handle it. And it served me well during my playing career.
And the shots just continue to say no in terms of falling.
On the sideline, let's catch up with Hall of Famer David Aldridge.
Kevin, Josh Richardson has made himself into one of the top defensive wings in the league. Richardson says there's a certain competitiveness that comes with being a good defender. The defensive end takes will, and I have a lot of it. Kevin J. Rich is self-described as super competitive, and that edge is what drives him.
It sure is. That's what it takes. Thank you, David. There's 39 seconds left here in the third quarter.
And in that first half, guys, they didn't shoot nearly as many threes as they have here in the second, trying to use that shot to stay in the game. That's a surprise. I mean, really out of character for him to miss when the defense is not right up on him. And all you got to do is look at the rebounding margin as to why they hold the lead.
And you know what? That tells the story in a lot of games, guys. And here you go. It's telling the story tonight, too.
We've got 13 seconds left in the third quarter. Here's Burks. The rebound by Giles.
And the activity he shows around the rim is why he is such a respected defender.
And you know what? He's not going to give up an easy finish at the rim. I mean, that's...
And so it's Sacramento, leading by a full 31 points at the end of the quarter. A look at the field goal percentage numbers tells the story of what tough defense they're playing today. We come back right after this. And one quarter to go in a game that to this point has not been an evenly fought contest.
And hustle like that is why he leads his team in rebounds tonight.
And I tell you what, guys, nobody's been more physical in this game than he has. He has been a glass eater.
And he's got such a great touch and feel around the basket. He made that reverse look easy.
Scott. The shot missing. From deep. They get it back. Bagley with the bucket. And that's a double-double for him now. 11 points and 26 rebounds.
And the dogged attitude of Bagley. When shots go up, he wants to be the first to pounce on misses.
And the Kings pushing it up now. Parker leading the charge.
And thus far, they've managed to overcome an off game from him offensively.
Got a piece of it. And he recovers it. And they'll keep possession. Another miss by Philadelphia. A pass to Fox. Back to Parker. And the foul on Glenn Robinson. That'll be his second foul of the game. Clark, here's kind of an interesting perspective question for you. How much of making it to the NBA is talent?
how much of it is the work you put into it?
Kevin, if I were to give this a ratio, I would probably say 65% talent, 35% work ethic, because you have to have a level of unique giftedness to be an NBA player. Many can work really hard and not be NBA caliber. So I think there's, I tilt that 65-35 talent to work ethic.
In the fourth quarter, their defense has been very strong, allowing no baskets. Count that one. Parker's got four this quarter.
And defensively, they are on their heels every time the ball comes inside.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness, Greg. I mean, if they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
And there's the defensive 3-second call. Guys, what do you think about the offensive approach so far that we've seen for Sacramento?
Anytime you get as many points in the paint as they have, you know you've got a good thing going and you just want to keep it going.
Yeah, but also, they haven't missed a beat in terms of their fast break game. That's been equally as effective all night long.
The drive by Scott over Parker. Another miss by Philadelphia.
Nothing seems to be going his way this quarter.
To me, it appears he's starting to lose his composure a little bit. We'll see if he can regroup and get back into a better rhythm.
Here's O'Quinn. It's deflected.
And, you know, this is really what Brewer does quite well, Kevin. Extending out nicely and swatting away shots.
You know what? You've got to always be in control of your emotions.
Great frustration right there, and I agree with you. Self-control of your emotions, a must-have if you're going to play winning basketball.
Six on the shot clock. Let's go. And he can't bank that one in. And the 76ers with possession. Looking to get on the board here in the fourth still.
You know, he's just not taking good shots, not taking smart shots, forcing up a lot of low-percentage junk there.
But the relationship between referees and players reaching a fever pitch. What can be done to smooth those waters and mend those fences?
Well, I think first and foremost, players have to give. Both sides have to give in this equation, but I think it's incumbent upon the players to accept and respect the position of the officials. The officials have to also be willing to engage and interacting well with the players. It's a two-way street, but I think most of that is on the players because they have to control how they respond to officials more than officials have to respond to the players.
Both teams will make substitutions.
And so it's going to end up in the record books as a blowout, a dominating performance for the Kings.
You don't see this kind of a blowout often. But tonight, this is a quality win across the board to deliver out this kind of punishment.
They definitely never changed the approach. They just kept after it and showed they were clearly the better team in just about every single category.
And so it'll boost this year's win total for them to 29.
And this is a great way for them to kick off this season series. Two more games ahead, and they've taken the mental advantage with this win tonight.
Greg, I don't think it'll play out quite that simply, though. The team coming out on the losing end of game one is just that much more motivated to get even in game two and three. So I think the edge goes to the losing team.
And you know, when you look at the huge impact he had, just a monster game for Marvin Bagley.
Yeah, and he was aggressive rebounding the ball tonight. I think his aggressiveness on the glass helps set the tone.
Out to the right wing. Here's Korkmaz, and it doesn't even draw iron. Bagley, no good.
Yeah, and that was lining up to be a huge alley-oop, but they just couldn't quite connect.
And you know, guys, always a tough catch on the lob. Placement and timing have to be close to perfect.
And the ball out of play. The Kings will inbound. There's 14 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Here's Fox. Here's Parker. and a good offensive board and against the bucket.
Well, I tell you what, tremendous work rate in getting to the glass by Parker. If you don't box him out, he'll make you pay for it.
And so it's Sacramento easily grabbing this one. This one was over well before the final buzzer. The fans were waiting for something to get excited about, Greg, but they never got it.
They sure didn't. I mean, they just rolled to this win. They made it look really easy. What an efficient performance at both ends.
And that's going to do it tonight, folks. For-